Okay, guys, we're doing a holiday drawing. We're going to be using a string of Christmas lights. Going to give you a lot of options here for this drawing. You could literally just look at the lights and draw it as a still life by laying it out exactly the way you want to see it. That would be great. You could use it as just inspiration. And as you can see from this painted one, some of the lights are large and small, so there was a lot of creativity here changing it. Or you could do a combination of both. You could look obviously at what you see and then make some changes. The first thing I want you to think about is how you're going to lay it out, your composition. Many things we talked about in composition. In this lesson, the thing that you need to keep in mind is your use of positive and negative space. Negative space is the background, which is all of these shapes here, and positive is what I'm drawing. So the first thing I'm going to do is decide generally where my strings are going to go. I'm doing this dark for you. You can do this very light because these things might need to be erased. So as I lay this down, I'm deciding how I'm going to divide up my space so that there is equal amount of interesting negative space and positive space. One thing that you can do that makes this work really well is to have things come on and off the page. By having something go off the page, as you see here, it naturally creates great negative space. Okay, at this point, I'm going to start drawing my lights on where I want, keeping in mind movement, line direction, and positive negative space. One thing that can be done to make this a little bit easier, if you want all your lights the same size, is I went over to the scrap box and I got a piece of construction paper and I simply folded it in half since it is a symmetrical image and I cut a light bulb. So now all I have to do is place it down and I don't have to struggle with making all of my lights exact same size. And I could kind of look, having things go on and off the page. This would be perfect if you want your lights to be the same size, but you might not want them. Let's look at this one here. This is a color pencil one. So this is a great option too. If you don't choose to paint yours in tempera paint, you can use color pencil. With this, you would look at your shading. This would be a lesson on value. And I want to speak to you real quickly about that. You can see here in the sketch that the student did that there's a lot of highlights, and as you can see in the light itself, where the overhead lights reflect in. When you are creating highlights, you want to put that down on the paper or know exactly where your highlights are going to be, as you see here, prior to coloring in, because it's very difficult to erase up color pencil. It can be done though, but keeping in mind before you begin coloring where you're going to place your highlights, it just makes the job a little bit easier. Two things about the color pencil lesson, which is a review. Overlap your color pencils, overlays. So even though this is orange, I see a lot of dark oranges. The way I create that is by going to the right or left of the color on the color wheel. So to the right on the color wheel would be red, to the left of an orange would be yellow. So I would take those three colors to create this. Not every highlight is completely white. Some of them can be kind of softer, but that's how you're going to get your value. And this all goes on and off the page, and it makes a very interesting design. There is the possibility of you just leaving this as a pencil sketch, and that's okay if you want it black and white. But you're going to be creating a holiday light design, keeping in mind positive and negative space, a good composition, shadowing, and using value in order to create form. And these are all principles and elements of art.